Hi guys.
Today let us see about linear equations. From linear equations, the questions like problems on edges and problems on shares, like that, the questions will be asked from linear equations. So let us see what are the terms used in linear equations. The first one is variable. A variable, what is variable? An unknown quantity is called variable. A known quantity is called a constant. An unknown quantity is called a variable. Then next one is, what is expression? Which does not include any symbol is called expression. This is expression. It is involving a variable. These constants 5 and 4 are constants and x is a variable. So this is an expression. There is no equality symbol or inequality symbol. So this is an expression. Then what is equation? A statement which equates two expressions having one or more variables. This is the expression. If two expressions are equated or joined with a symbol, then it is called as equation. See here, x square plus 2 is an expression and y plus 4 is another expression. This equation may be of one variable or more than one variables, like x plus 2 is equal to 2x minus 4. This is also an equation. Then what is an equation? If inequality symbol exists between the two expressions, then it is called as an equation. Suppose x plus 2 is less than x minus 4. This is an equation. And we are dealing about linear equations today. Then what is linear equation? Equation is a statement which equates two expressions. It is called equation. And what is linear equation? An equation with degree 1 is called linear equation. What is degree? The power should be 1. Variable power should be 1. Here, y power 1, x power 1. Like that. If there is an expression like this, xy plus x plus y is equal to 0, then is it a linear equation? No, because the power of this, the individual powers are x power 1, y power 1, but the total power of this term is 2 and this term is 1, this term is 1, but here the power is 2, so it is not a linear equation. This is a linear equation. The linear equation may be of one variable, two variable, or more variables. Let us see what is linear equation with one variable. If the linear equation has one variable, then it is called linear equation with one variable. This is the example. X plus 2 is equal to 4 is one example. Y minus 3 is equal to 2 is one example. Like that. A linear equation with one variable. And what is linear equation with two variables? A linear equation consisting of two variables is called linear equation with two variables. So here, if you see here, 5x plus 4y plus 9 is equal to 6. There are two variables and the power of the variable is 1. So this is equation with degree 1 having two variables. So it is called as linear equation with two variables. Generally, this is represented like this. Linear equation with one variable is represented by ax plus b is equal to 0, where a is not equal to 0. This is representation of linear equation with one variable. And representation of linear equation with two variables is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, where a not equal to 0 and b is also not equal to 0. And let us see how the problems are asked based on linear equations. The question directly does not give, it will not be given directly the linear equations. A question is given and we should frame it, and we should frame that into linear equation, and then we solve that linear equation. So here, there is a question here. Father's age is 8 times the age of son. Before 2 years, the father's age was 15 times the age of son. what are the percentages of father and son? Let us take the percentages. Percentages of father as F and son as S. And first statement is father's age is 8 times the age of son. Percentage of father is 8 times the age of son. Before 2 years, father's age was 15 times the age of son. What is before 2 years? Percentage of father is F. Before 2 years, father's age will be F minus 2. And father's age before 2 years is 15 times age of son. What is son's age before 2 years? S minus 2. Okay, this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. So what it is asked to find? What are the percentages of father and son? So we need to find F and S. In order to find F and S, we substitute this one in this 2. So F is 8S. By substituting 8S in place of F, 8S minus 2 is equal to 15S minus 30. Then it will be, if you take 8S here, 15S minus 8S is 7S is equal to, here it will be 28. Taking 30 this side. So S is equal to 7, 4 times, 7, 4 is 28. So age of son is 4 years. And what is the age of father? F is equal to 8S. So 8 into age of son is 4. So 8, 4 is 32. So age of son is 4. And the age of father is 32. This is how we need to solve the ages problem. We should convert the question into first linear equations. These two are linear equations, and then we solve the linear equations. And the next one is simultaneous linear equations with two variables. We have seen only one equation, right? If there are two equations, these are called system of linear equations, simultaneous linear equations, where the values of, if we substitute a certain x and y values, these x and y values are satisfied for both the equations. Let us see this by an example. If these x and y values are satisfied for both the equations, then those are called as simultaneous linear equations. There is an example here. 8x plus 6y is equal to 28 and 6x plus 4y is equal to 22. And if we substitute x is equal to 5 and y is equal to minus 2, these values are satisfied for both the equations. If we substitute 5 value in this equation 1, 8 into 5 plus 6 into, what is the value of 1? Minus 2, which is equal to 28. 8 5 is 14 minus 6 to the 12 is equal to 28. So 28 is equal to 28. LHS is equal to RHS. This equation 1 is satisfied. If you substitute the x and y values in second equation, 6 into 5 plus 4 into minus 2 is equal to 22. 6 5 is 30 minus 4 2 is 8 is equal to 22. Therefore, 22 is equal to 22. And this is also satisfied. So the values of x and y are satisfied for both the equations. So these two equations are called as simultaneous linear equations. There are two types of linear equations. One is consistent and inconsistent. If there is an equation like this, x minus 2 is equal to 4, then if I ask you to find the solution, then you will be saying x is equal to 6. So the finding the answer of variable is called solution. This is solution of this equation. So for any equation, the solution may exist or may not exist. Based on this, the linear equations are divided into two types. The first one is consistent linear equation and the second one is inconsistent linear equation. What is consistent linear equation? Equation having the solution is called consistent, and equation not having the solution is called inconsistent. Let us see this consistent linear equation with an example. There is equation like two equations, simultaneous linear equation. From this, x is equal to, what is the solution of first equation? It will be 2, because sending this to this side, it will be 2, and for this it is x is equal to 2. So x is equal to 2 is solution of the system of linear equations. And if we see in inconsistent, see here, for this equation it will be x is equal to 2, and for this equation it will be x is equal to 4. So there is no single value. Is there any single value which is satisfying this system of linear equations? No. So these two are inconsistent system of linear equations. There is no solution, which means there is no value of x which is satisfying those linear equations. So these two are inconsistent linear equations. So how to solve this system of linear equations? This can be solved by many methods. Let us see the most popular methods, which are elimination method, substitution method, and adding and subtracting method. The first one is elimination method. What is elimination method? We need to eliminate any one variable. We can eliminate by like this. Suppose this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. In order to eliminate any element, if we need to eliminate variable x, then we need to multiply this equation with 2. If we need to eliminate y, we need to multiply this equation with 4, because if we multiply with 2, it will be, this will become 2x, 2y, and here it will become 120. And if we multiply with 4, it will become 4x, 4y, and here 240. And then this 4 gets cancelled, 4y, 4y gets cancelled, right? So first we should select the variable which we need to eliminate. Let us say here, we solve this problem by eliminating x. I have selected to eliminate the variable x. So in order to eliminate x, we need to multiply this equation with a constant 2 and subtract it with equation 2. So 2 into equation 1, it will be 2x plus 2y is equal to 120, and here the minus equation 2. Equation 2 is 2x plus 4y is equal to 160. Here there is subtractive symbol. So minus, minus, minus. 2x minus 2x gets cancelled. 2y minus 4y is minus 2y. And here 120 minus 160 is minus 40. Minus, minus gets cancelled. And y is equal to 20. From this we can find x by substituting this value in equation 1. X plus y is equal to 60, right? So x plus y is equal to 60, x plus 20 is equal to 60, and x is equal to 40. The value of x is 40 and value of y is 20. Let us solve the same problem by substitution method. In substitution method, we take any variable in terms of another variable. If you see here, this is one equation and this is one equation. If I take x variable in terms of y variables, it will be 60 minus y by sending y to RHS. So if we substitute this 60 minus y in place of x in the second equation, we get 2 into what is x? 60 minus y plus 4y is equal to 160. Then it will be 120 minus 2y plus 4y is equal to 160, and here it will be 120 plus 2y is equal to 160, and again 2y is equal to 160 minus 120, it will be 40, y is equal to 20. We got y as 20, and if we substitute this in the equation 1, what is equation? This x is equal to 60 minus y, right? So x is equal to 60 minus y which is 60 minus 20, which is equal to 40. So x is equal to 40 and y is equal to 20. What we got here, x is equal to 40, y is equal to 20. And the next one is adding and subtracting method. This method is not widely used, but some equations can be solved by this adding and subtracting method. So here, let us say this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Here, if we add equation 1 and 2, we get 4x plus 5y is equal to 41, and 5x plus 4y is equal to 40. If we add these two, here it will be 9x plus 9y is equal to 81. From this we get x plus y, taking 9 as common, it will be 81. So 9 9s are 81. Here it will be x plus y is equal to 9. If we add this, it will be x plus y is equal to 9. And if we subtract 1 and 2, we subtract this, 4x plus 5y is equal to 41, and minus 5x minus 4y and is equal to minus 40. Then it will be 4x minus 5x is minus x, and 5y minus 4y is plus y is equal to 1. If we send this to here and this to here, it will be x minus y is equal to minus 1. Let us say this as equation 3 and this as equation 4. See here, we got x, single x, single y, single x, single x, single y. Or we may get the coefficients like 2x, 2y, 2x, 2y. We may get the same coefficients for x and y variables. This type of equations can be solved by adding and subtracting method. So what we got? Equation 3 and equation 4. By adding 3 and 4, we get x plus y is equal to, what is x plus 1? It is 9. X plus y is 9. And what is x minus y? It is minus 1. X minus y is equal to minus 1. If we solve this, it is 2x, y gets cancelled, and it will be 8. So x is equal to 4. And if we want to find y, x plus y is equal to 9. So what is x? X is 4 plus y is equal to 9. Then y will be 9 minus 4, which is equal to 5. So the value of y is 5 and value of x is 4. This is how we need to solve the simultaneous linear equations problem using elimination method, substitution method, and addition and subtraction method. So what are the linear equations, types of linear equations? It will be consistent linear equations and inconsistent linear equations. So this is the concept of linear equation, total concept of linear equation. In the next video, we will solve some problems based on linear equations, different types of problems based on linear equations. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe the channel. Thank you.